Very good morning to all the children. So, beta, we were discussing Albert Einstein at school, and am I audible to all? Kindly send me feedback, and then I'll start. So, let's have a look at the key points. Those who were not present, for them. So, basically, this is based on education system. What sort of system? Factual versus imaginary, or factual versus based on ideas. Fine. So we are asked to cram facts in history. We are asked to cram the concepts. So according to Einstein, education should have, it should be based on ideas and imagination and creativity, basically, rather than being fixed to what was happening, and rather than we should concentrate on why that happened. Clear? So problems faced by students. So Einstein faced a lot of problems where he was living in a rented room in a very, you can say, pathetic condition. Landlady was very annoying. She used to beat her children, and he was not able to follow his studies as well as hobbies over there. Then teacher-taught relation is the next theme in which we'll get to know that how teachers, they treat children, and you know, the way you are treated, that will shape your future also in one or the other way. If you are mistreated all the time, that will affect your performance many a times. And if you are getting positive reinforcement, positive feedback, appreciation for doing something good, not because without any reason, but if you do something good, you're getting appreciation, positive reinforcement, then definitely you are going to show, you know, right path you will get, you will follow, and you will achieve success. In this, Einstein was not having good relation with Mr. Braun, history teacher. Reason being, teacher was, the way he answered to teacher was also not good. The teacher also, you know, asked n number of questions. That was so, that moment was actually not that good. That conversation should not be there in between a teacher and taught. That seems to be rude. But if students are having, you know, respectful attitude towards the teachers, and teachers also take care of that, how to speak to the children. We should not take it for granted, fine? So only then that healthy relationship should be there, so that students are encouraged to learn better, fine? So this is teacher-taught relation. Where were you? 10 minutes passed. So let's read from page number 27, beta. You can open your books. Children at home, I'll be sharing screen soon. So please open page 27 first. I doubted, said Albert glumly. So on page by 26, we have read that when his friend Yuri and he both, they are discussing the condition at their own places where they're residing. So when Albert Einstein was complaining that my landlady is very annoying, she beats her children, she herself is beaten up by her husband on every Saturday. So then Yuri jumps up to his rescue by saying that, okay, you are facing problem, I am facing worst problem, even when I compare it with you. Because where I reside, people are murderers and they want scars to be seen on their faces as a sign that they have achieved something, and they are wandering freely. They are not behind the bars. So there I am living, and you are in a better condition than mine. So then it, discussion ended. Then page 27 we are going to read. Okay, and I'm going to share the screen with you all. Let's continue page 27. I guess there is some problem. It's not moving. You have to bear for a minute. System has hanged at a place only. It's not moving. Okay, let it be. I'll try to share again for once. Yes, now you can see the screen. Yes, now it's working. पेज नंबर 27. यस बेटा सेंड मी इफ यू आर एबल टू सी इट. ओके फाइन खैर सी आई डाउट इट सेड एल्बर्ट ग्लमली. आई डोंट थिंक आई एवर पास द एग्जाम्स फॉर द स्कूल डिप्लोमा. So Albert was not worried about that he is not getting facilities. He was worried about that he cannot concentrate on his studies. That is getting affected. Clear? He told his cousin Elsa. Now next character, I already discussed with you yesterday all the characters. So underline this name. Elsa, the same next time she came to Munich. So she was very supportive. She came to Munich and then he's discussing this thing with Elsa also. Normally, she lived in Berlin where her father had a business. I am sure you could learn enough to pass the exams, Albert, if you tried. So now, first conversation was with Yuri about the places they were residing. Now, the conversation with Elsa regarding study, cramming, the way you discuss with your friends, karte ho na, that I cannot... learn the formula, मेरे को ये chapter समझ में नहीं आ रहा, I'm not able to concentrate in chemistry or physics or bio or whatever tough subjects you feel. The same way he's discussing this thing with his cousin Elsa, who has come there to meet him, and she's saying that why are you so underconfident? If you have tried, definitely you will pass. I know lots of boys who are much more stupid than you, and who get through. Get through means they get easily passing marks. When getting through means getting through the examination, going to the next level. So she's saying that even more, there are some boys, you are much better than them. And you are saying that you will not pass. They say you don't have to know anything. You don't have to understand what you are taught. Just be able to repeat it in the exam. See, and this is happening in reality, I have seen. There are children who never prepare, but anyhow... in MCQ system specifically, you know, guesswork is there, or they try to ask others, they try to cheat. And the one who is working harder day and night, you are studying and they are getting equal marks sometimes. Fine. So it happens, but it is not long-term investment for such students. They will not, because you have to appear for subjective also as well. One time your luck will work, or by chance you got good marks. It will not happen again and again. The level of MCQs are going to be different next time. Fine, every time you're not going to score easily. Fine, so in this, she has discussed that there are boys who are very casual, but they say just cram it and write down and you will pass. That's the whole trouble, said Albert. I'm no good at learning things by heart. He says, I cannot cram the things. I cannot learn by heart. He's the boy who understands the things actually. You don't need to be good at it. Anyone can learn like a parrot. You just don't try. And I always see you with a book under your arm. I did, Elsa. What is the one you are reading? A book on zoology. Zoology, fine. It's ology always. Biology ni bolo gaya, biology. Fine, the pronunciation. Ology is combined. Biology, zoology, fine. So... he always used to carry one book under his arm, Albert Einstein, fine? And he was very fond of reading the things which he was having interest in. So Elsa asked her cousin that why you carry this book? And he told that this is a book on zoology and zoology, rocks and things. Do you learn that? No, we have hardly any science at school. So this book was not taught at school. He was having the interest. He bought it and he got it from somewhere. He started reading. Then why are you studying it? Because I like it. Isn't that a good enough reason? See, so whether a person who reaches the success, first and foremost thing is choose the stream or subject you love. You have interest in. You understand. Just because others are taking it, we should not follow that way. Because we have to prove it to society? No. Big cross. Because our parents are asking us or teachers are pressurizing us? No. Never ever. if you have chosen medical, you should have a strong reason to give justification to yourself, not to others. You're not here to prove others, okay? So we have to prove it to ourselves only. Clear? So he says, this is the enough reason that I liked this. That's why I'm reading it. You are right, of course, Albert, she said, but it won't help with your diploma. Diploma is that course which he's pursuing or the class in which he's studying. So she's saying, this will not fetch you marks. What will you do? Apart from books on science, his only comfort was music. Underline the interests of Albert Einstein. His only comfort was music. He played his violin regularly until his landlady asked him to stop. So he loved to play violin, but landlady used to interrupt him a lot. That wailing gets on my nerves, she said. Wailing is crying sound, Rona, uchi uchi. She's saying that, what is a violin? According to her, this is an instrument which produces wailing or crying sounds. Because the person who is not a music lover, he will not, you know, respect music, or he will not understand what music is all about. So she never liked it. Clear? That wailing gets on my nerves. There is enough noise in this house with all the kids howling. So she says that already my kids keep on spreading noise, keep on shouting and howling. So it's enough. Albert was tempted to point out that most of the time it was she who made them howl, but he decided it was better to say nothing. So us time Albert ko laga ki I should tell this lady why your kids shout because of you. You beat them regularly, then they cry, then they howl. But usko laga nahi, I should not say this to her. Again, it will lead to one more fight. He never wanted to go into the scuffles. Then I must get away from here, he told Yuri, after 6 months alone in Munich. It is absurd that I should go on like this. In the end, it will turn out I have been wasting my father's money and everyone's time. It will be better for all if I stop now. So in Munich, he did not like the education system. When he was forced to learn facts and crayons and things. So he thought, rather than doing the thing which you do not fit in, you do not like, rather I should stop here. So he asked his friend Yuri. This is the biggest problem faced by children. I was talking about nervous breakdown. It means sometimes we do not realize that we are facing a mental torture. You have a poster in your class, Mental Health Matters. That each year, data written on the chart is, each year one in five of us experiences a mental health problem. See the data, one out of five each year. Let's talk about mental health. It could save a life. So it matters, because people, you know, talk about the visible things. He's not feeling well, he has migraine, he's having physical problem. Mental health dikhta nahi hai kisi ko na. We do not know, I do not know what problems you are going through in your life. You do not know what problems I am going through. So in that way, everybody is fighting their own battle. So this boy is going to the extent of leaving the school. It means he is going through mental problem or a tough days of life. He's not able to, you know, accept what is happening to him. Clear? So, but it is better he's talking about it. Some people, they keep on, you know, doing the things which they do not like even. They ended up after failing. They ended up after having negative things. So he decided that I must leave this place even after 6 months. Abhi 6 months hue the. I must get away from here. And then what will you do? Yuri asked. I don't know. If I go to Milan, I am afraid my father will send me back. Milan is the place where his parents are residing in Paris. Fine. So he says, if I go to Milan, I don't know, my parents will send me back. What will I do? I will be better if I stop now. He says, his eyes gleamed with a sudden idea. Yuri, do you know any friendly doctors? Fine. So I was discussing that his eyes gleamed with a sudden idea. Yuri, do you know any friendly doctors? Means he went to that extent of thinking that I should see a doctor and I should get a certificate, a fake certificate that I'm going through a problem. I will hand over that certificate to authorities and I will leave this institution, right? So that if a child can go to that extent, it means he is facing some problem psychologically. He's not able to accept the present situation, fine? So he did not like the system over there and he was being tortured at lodgings also where he was residing. He was being tortured in the school also. He wanted to study some other subjects, but they were not, you know, school systems were not following what he wanted. He thought of quitting from there and he invented that idea. Actually, he wanted fake certificate of nervous breakdown, but actually he is going through that problem. He does not know. That's why I was discussing that mental health matters. We are not knowing that from which problem we are going through. So he asked, his eyes gleamed with the idea that, do you know any friendly doctors? I know a lot of medical students. Yuri answered that I know there are some students. Some of them are friendly. Doctor, no, I have never had money to go to one. Why? Suppose, said Albert, that I had a nervous breakdown. Suppose a doctor would say it's bad for me to go to school and I need to get right away from it. So this is the idea, underline this. He wanted to get away from this school. He thought, I will say that I will get a certificate from a good doctor, a registered doctor. He will give this certificate to me that I'm suffering from this nervous breakdown and I will give to authorities and they will send me back. And my parents will also, you know, will not get annoyed. So that was the way out he found. So we are on page number 28 now. Yes, please. I can't imagine a doctor saying that, said Yuri. I must try, said Albert, to find a doctor who specializes in nerves. So Yuri said, I don't think so. Any doctor will say this for you. Said Albert said that I must try to find a doctor. He is who is specializing in the nerves, nervous system. Fine. So it is the problem of brain only. Whatever instructions we are getting, these are from directly from brains. And if you people are having nervous breakdown, it means their brain is not giving them proper instructions. They get underconfident. And sometimes they even faint, fine, people out of nervousness. You know, you might have seen people that those hands start shaking with fear. Some people have perspiration on their face. That is also a sign. Fine, they are not able to face the situation. And some are also overconfident. Fine, there are some people who are very overconfident. So n number of personalities. So let's talk about Albert. There are plenty of them, Yuri told him. He hesitated for a moment and then added rather reluctantly. Reluctantly means he was not sure about it. Mana karna, jisko keh dete. Hesitant he was. I'll ask some of the students if they know one, if you like. Will you? Oh, thank you, Yuri. Albert's eyes were shining. Wait a moment. I have not found one yet. So Yuri says, I'm trying. I will try for you. I'm not sure ki I will find a doctor. I can ask some medical students, those who are becoming doctor or those who have recently become a doctor, because an experienced doctor will never give such certificate to us. Fine. He says, okay, you will do it. Thank you for that. And if I do, I do not know if he will be willing to help you. So Yuri is not sure that whether anybody will write for you or not. He will, declared Albert. I'm going to have a real nervous breakdown to make it easier for him. He laughed merrily. So he's taking it as a joke that I will have real problem of nervous breakdown and he will have to give a certificate, but actually he's going through it without knowing it. And if I do, I don't know if he'll be willing to help you. Okay, fine. I have never seen you looking less nervous, remarked Yuri, remarked correctly. He said, I never saw you looking less nervous. A day or two at school will soon put that right, Albert assured him. Certainly, he had lost his high spirits when Yuri saw him next. I can't stand it any longer, he said. I really shall have a nervous breakdown that will satisfy any doctor. So next time when they met, again, he was very depressed, Albert. So Yuri and he came to visit him. Albert declared that definitely, mujhko lag raha hai ki I'm definitely going through nervous breakdown because I'm not able to survive here. So keep it up then, said Yuri. I have found a doctor for you. So that day he came to just tell him that I have found a doctor. He was so happy to hear this news. I have an appointment for you tomorrow evening, Yuri said. Here is the address. He handed Albert a piece of paper. Now the last character, fine, we discussed yesterday. Dr. Ernst Wiehl, underline this name, double underline, all the characters you should know. The full name is Dr. Ernst Wiehl. He's a specialist in nervous troubles, asked Albert. Not exactly, Yuri admitted. As a matter of fact, he only qualified as a doctor last week. You may even be his first patient. You knew him as a student then. I have known Ernst for years. Yuri hesitated for a few moments. He's not a fool. He warned Albert. So Albert was not sure whether he's a good doctor or not. He was not a specializing doctor in nervous breakdown, but he was a doctor, recently passed out doctor a week ago. What do you mean? He says he's not a fool. Yes, he is a doctor. Degree mil chuka hai, he's a doctor. So he's saying that, what do you think? Yuri said, he's not a fool. Don't try to pull the wool over his eyes. Means, wool over eyes means don't cheat him. To cheat, fine? Be frank with him. So Yuri is giving instructions to Albert Einstein that if you meet the doctor, do not take him as a foolish person. He's a very smart person. Do not try to cheat him. Don't create stories in front of him. Tell him, fine? You are the world's worst liar. Underline, very important question. This has been there many times because this is the base. Yuri calls Albert Einstein, you are the world's worst liar. You tell me why. Now, this is your question. Kuch participate nahi kiya na abhi tak, bolo. Why he calls? Whatever you feel like. Galat ho jayega, koi baat nahi ho jayega. But you have to tell me. Yes. Think. Online children, you can also bit answer. Why he was called? Why Yuri calls his friend Albert world's worst liar? Jhoot bolna sabko aata hai? Straightforward, a very good Harman. Or he had honesty is there, yes. Because, you know, sometimes we think that we are making others be fool, but fine. So world's worst liar. Ab samajh mein aa gaya sabko? You are easily, you know, the opposite person can easily perceive you sometimes, catch your that stealing act. And you pretend that, but why? Because you are a good person. Then, ye compliment hai ke comment hai? Now tell me. Again, you are not able to understand. If I say you are world's worst liar, is it a comment on your personality or a compliment? Compliment hai, Diljit is saying compliment. Divnur kehti nahi nahi nahi. Compliment hai, Nidhi says compliment hai. Comment hai, according to Raman. Comment. So it can be taken in both ways. If I say that you do not know how to tell a lie, you are the worst liar. So it is a kind of compliment in that case. That is a praise. That ki dekho jhoot hi nahi bolna. So in that way, he is saying that he knew that my friend cannot deceive anyone. He cannot cheat anyone. Fine. So that's why he says this. You are the world's worst liar. You won't be able to tell a lie to even to the doctor. Fine. Albert spent the next day wondering what to tell the doctor. Ab pata laga, next line padke. He spent the next whole day wondering what to tell the doctor. जिसको झूठ बोलना है उसको तो ऐसे बोलना होता है, उसको सोचना ही नहीं पड़ता. सो ही स्पेंडिंग अ होल डे. व्हाट विल आई से टू द डॉक्टर व्हेन द टाइम अराइव्ड फॉर हिज अपॉइंटमेंट. ही हैड वरीड ओवर इट सो मच दैट ही बिकेम रियली नर्वस. ही थॉट टू मच. ओवर थिंकिंग मेक्स यू नर्वस. आई डोंट रियली नो हाउ टू डिस्क्राइब माई ट्रबल डॉक्टर व्हील ही बिगैन. आउट ऑफ नर्वसनेस ही टोल्ड वेरी ब्लंटली ऑनेस्टली, डॉक्टर आई डोंट रियली नो हाउ टू डिस्क्राइब माई ट्रबल. Doctor is very smart. He says, don't try. Young doctor with a friendly smile. Your age has nothing to do with your... Sometimes experienced people are not good enough in handling also. Sometimes a young person is able to handle you in a good way. So he's a young doctor, but he's very smart. Yuri has already given me a history of the case. So he says, Yuri has told me about you. You need not tell. Oh, what did he say? Only that you want me to think... You have had a nervous breakdown and say that you must not go back to that school. So Yuri has already informed the doctor. Okay, this is the case that my friend wants you to give a certificate to him mentioning that he has a nervous breakdown. So he is already clear about the case study. Case study kya hoti? History of the patient. Oh dear, Albert's face fell. He was ashamed. He thought, what has Yuri done? He has already told the doctor about what I thought of not telling. He should not have told you that. Doctor says, why not? Isn't it true then? Yes, that's the trouble. Now you will say that there is nothing wrong with me. You will tell me to go back to school. Don't be too sure of that, said the doctor. Because doctor was able to perceive that this boy is going through the problem of nervous breakdown. That's why he thought and took such grave step. We will continue on next Thursday. Have a nice day.